I'm going to tell you about the different Copilot licenses, the differences between them, and which one you need. As a bonus, I'm also going to tell you about the designers for Copilot. By the end of this video, you're going to know what you need, why you need it, and what your next steps are. Now, there's timestamps in the video description below because I value your time and you already know why you're here. Let's get into it. Now, the first one is Copilot, just plain old Copilot, the free one, because it's already included with your Microsoft license. Now, there's certain Microsoft licenses that already come with a Copilot license. So those are on the screen right now. But what this is going to give you is chat capability with Copilot. Now, this flavor of Copilot was known as Bing Chat or Bing Chat Enterprise. If you notice now, it shows Copilot at the top of the Bing interface. So that's where you can find this particular Copilot. Now, this Copilot has text, voice, and image capabilities built into it. For the images, you'll want to head to Designer, where you'll be able to have Copilot create you images using Dolly. Not this Dolly, this Dolly. You'll also have 15 boosts per day to create images. Now, what a boost is during peak times, you know, at times when you're creating images, the system's gonna have, you know, a various amount of load on it throughout the day. So a lot of times the images can take a little bit to create. I've seen it take close to a minute on some of my testing, but if you apply a boost, it will speed up that image creation. So you can get your images faster, but up to 15 a day. But this is the starting Copilot. It only goes up from here. So those boosts will be going up as we go up in tier. You also get plugin support, so you will be able to bring in plugins to your Copilot and add additional functionality. And lastly, when you're having a conversation with Copilot, a conversation with AI, I guess it's a conversation. So when you're having a conversation with Copilot, it's going to be doing web grounding. That's what Microsoft calls this. And what web grounding is it's going to be pulling in information from the web, different internet sources, to make sure it's giving you accurate information. Now, obviously, Copilot on its own is AI, and it can provide you a lot of information that it already knows about. But pulling in external content from the internet will help it make sure it has accurate results to give you when you're giving it various prompts. And the way that web grounding works is it's going to be using the Bing web API service. So it's not going to be using Google or any other web service. It's using Bing because, of course, it's Microsoft. It makes sense. Next, we're going to talk about Copilot Pro. Now, this is one step up from the regular Copilot, and this is going to give you more advanced capabilities for home users. Both of these products, Copilot and Copilot Pro, are designed for home users or possibly small businesses, maybe, but definitely not enterprise. Now, Copilot Pro is going to give you priority access to the models, both 3.5 and GPT-4. Also with Pro, you're gonna have faster image creation, including 100 boosts per day now, instead of just the 15. So more capability, but you know, you're paying for that capability. Now with the image boosts, you could still create images if you're out of boosts. All this really means is that the images are going to be a little bit slower to get created after your boosts run out. But the big change when you go from Copilot to Copilot Pro is now you have Copilot in the office applications. You're not just stuck with the browser interface. Now you're going to have Word, Excel, PowerPoint. Now you won't have Teams. That's a difference between Copilot Pro and M365. Well, one of the differences. So you're going to have it in the home office applications, but that is a very, very big deal because now you're going to be able to crank up Word and have Copilot draft up documents, do revisions, things like that. It's not web chat anymore. You still have that, of course, but now you have contextually aware Copilot in your applications. So if you need to analyze data in Excel, things like that, it's all right there. So this is definitely a very big deal for just $20 a month, of course, depending on your budget. Third is going to be Copilot for Microsoft 365. This is the big one. This is the one that's $30 per user per month, depending on what country you're in. And this is the whole shebang as far as the Microsoft Office suite. You're going to have it in all of the Office applications, including Teams. So the one for Teams is going to let you do things like summarize meetings, catch up on things you've missed on if you completely missed a meeting, and all the other goodness that comes with the other Office application Copilots. And now Copilot Pro's big claim to fame is having Copilot in your Office applications. Copilot for M365 has got all of the data protection in there. Now what this means is your enterprise data security. So think Microsoft Purview, all of your compliance controls, data loss prevention, information protection, all of those things, that is all part of Copilot now with this particular edition. So all of the work that you've put in to secure your Microsoft 365 environment and keep data safe, all of that is going to be retained within Copilot for Microsoft 365. That means that if you've got sensitivity labels applied to data, that's going to be evident with the responses from Copilot for M365. This is a very big deal, and this is why Copilot for Microsoft 365 is currently the only Copilot of these three that is made for enterprise. It's made for your enterprise because it understands and respects all of the controls that you have placed on your data, and it honors it all. Also with Copilot for Microsoft 365, you'll have Copilot Studio, which is where you'll be creating your custom Copilots. Now to get this particular Copilot for M365, you're going to need a business standard or business premium license. So if you don't have those, you're not going to be able to apply Copilot licenses for those users. Now let's talk about the custom Copilot maker tools. These Copilot builders known as Copilot Studio and Copilot GPT Builder. So Copilot GPT Builder is available only for Copilot Pro users. Now this hasn't even come out yet, so we don't know all of the details, but we do know it is for Copilot Pro. You're going to be able to use it to create custom Copilots through conversational language. So you're going to more like describe to Copilot what you need this new custom Copilot to do, and it's going to be building this thing out for you. Now, as more details come out, we'll obviously know more, and I'll update you on what's going on with this particular new Copilot builder experience. But the big one is called Copilot Studio, and that is only for Copilot for M365. This is the one that lets you build out custom plugins, custom Copilots. You can bring in all sorts of information into these custom Copilots, and the interface looks a little bit like maybe Power Automate, if you're familiar with that, where it's like a flowchart type of a layout where you're going to tell it what to handle. You'll be able to configure topics that it can talk about and how it should handle those topics, how it should respond, how it should know if someone's bringing up one of those topics. So Copilot Studio is going to be part of Copilot for M365. And now it's not just as simple as getting Copilot Studio, because of course, things always have to be more complicated sometimes. I don't know. But Copilot Studio does come in a few different flavors, depending on whether you are paying $30 per user per month for a particular Copilot for M365 license, or you could buy Copilot Studio for the entire tenant at $200 per tenant per month. Now, depending on which one you're using will unlock different features, as you can see here. But one thing is clear, Copilot Studio is going to be the full interface to create your custom Copilots. Now, with all of these different options here, where you're having to pay monthly for a particular Copilot piece of functionality or license, you're going to have to purchase that license on an annual basis. You can't go month to month on these things. Now, one of the other things I wanted to touch on is the commercial data protection that Microsoft's been pushing out lately. It'll be pushing out updates for anyway. What the commercial data protection means is that your prompts and the responses to and from Copilot are not going to be saved anywhere. It's not going to be used to train the model. Microsoft will have no information about any of that stuff. So that is important, and Microsoft's rolling this out for more and more licenses. As recently as just a few days ago, I believe, additional licenses came out that will support commercial data protection. As of the date of the recording, these are all of the licenses that will have this particular feature. So the main takeaways are that if you're a home user, you should be looking at Copilot, the free one, or Copilot Pro. But if you're an enterprise and the only option for you to protect your data is going to be Copilot for Microsoft 365. But there's another one out there as well, and that's called Copilot for SharePoint. It's going to change all that you know about how to create content for SharePoint. And if you haven't heard about this one yet, then click or tap the screen to learn more about that. And let me know in the comments below what you're excited about using, which one of these Copilots. They're all so exciting to me, and I can't wait to get into all these new ones that are going to be coming out. So make sure you subscribe to the channel to get all the latest in Copilot and SharePoint.